My screen is visible, say yes, please.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Sir. So already, already in the last, good morning, everyone. So in the last class, we have started our journey of geometry, and we have started this beautiful chapter, Lines and Angles. And we discussed about so many things. I mean, what are the different types of lines, and what are the angles we have up to complete angle we have discussed. Then we talked about these lines. These lines can be parallel, they can be intersecting. Yes, they can be coinciding. Then we discussed about vertically opposite angles. Okay, all those things we have discussed, and I gave you some simple problem also. Then I asked you to solve the first exercise also, and I told you all the doubts will be cleared. So before getting into first exercise and second exercise, let me start this lines and angles second video. In the second video, you are going to get so much of details. Dear children, already we know about parallel lines, no? We heard about parallel lines. We got to know about parallel lines. Now this line, for example, I have got one line here, and I have got one more line here. Yes? Anyone? Are you able to see my screen, dear children?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. This is the line AB, and this is the line CD. Then we are going to write AB is parallel to CD. How to read this? You guys know, no? You know, right? AB is parallel to CD. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now on this, there will be a line cutting. For example, this is the line XY. For example, I am naming this line as XY. This XY, what is this? This is a line, line cutting parallel lines, line cutting parallel lines at two points. At two points, there are two points like this. Let me name those two points as, you can name them P and Q. You can name them as P and Q. So line cutting parallel lines at two points. What is this? What is the name for this? The name for this is a transversal. Have you heard this name transversal before, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Yes, so whatever XY is there, that is a transversal. Transversal means it's a line. You have to write it's a line cutting parallel lines at two points. Okay, it is cutting at two points. Now when it is cutting at two points, we are going to have so many angles here. No, look at that. This is one angle. Can you see the angle APX, dear children? We have one angle here. Look at this. There is one angle like this. Okay, what is this? APX. There is an angle like this. Correct? Here is the angle, no? This angle, APX. Right, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Yes or no? We are going to have so many angles. Let me name this as angle number one. And I have XPB, XPBB, XPB. Like that, that is angle number two. Then we have BPQ. This is angle number three. And this one is angle number four. And this one is angle number five. And this is angle number six. This is angle number seven. And this is angle number eight. Totally, there are eight angles, no, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So, whatever angle one and angle five are there, no, they are equal to each other. Angle one and angle five. We'll prove that also. And angle 2 and angle 6, whatever are there, no? Angle 1 and angle 5, angle 2 and angle 6. So both are both of these are equal, and these are called as what? These are called as corresponding angles. Yes. Yes. What are these? These are corresponding angles. Have you studied it in 8th standard also?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
1 and 5 and 2 and 6. Now we have angle 4 and 6, no? Angle 4 and 6. Can you see that? Yes. Angle 4 and 6, dear children? So angle 4 and 6. So again, we have angle 3 and 5. So angle 4 and 6 and angle 3 and 5, they are equal to each other, and they are called as alternate interior angles. What are those, dear children? Alternate interior angles. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Correct, no? Look at 4 and 6. 4 and 6. 3 and 5. Okay, alternate interior angles. Okay, interior because they are inside. Look at that, all the angles 4, 3, 6, 5, they are inside. That's why interior. Alternate because 4 and 6. 4 is on left side, 6 is on right side. That's why we call it as alternate interior angles. Is it understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, angle 1 and 7. Angle 1 and 7, angle 2 and 8. angle 1 and 7, look at this, angle 1 and 7, 2 and 8. So these are called as alternate exterior angles, dear children. So these are also equal to each other. These are called as alternate exterior angles. Why they are called alternate exterior angles? Because they are exterior, they are outside, they are not between the lines. And they are alternative. 1 is on left side, 7 is on right side. 2 is on right side, 8 is on left side. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Then after that, angle 4 and angle 5. Angle 4 plus angle 5, if you do, that becomes 180 degree. Angle 4 and angle 5. This is the property, okay? And if you do angle 3 and angle 6, that also becomes 180 degree. Angle 3 and angle 6. Look at this. 3 and 6, 4 and 5. So 4 and 5 together 180, 3 and 6 together 180. So these are called as interior angles on same side. Interior angles on same side. Interior angles on same side of transversal. This is also one more property. Understood, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this together, so whatever angle 4 is there, angle 5 is there, together it becomes 180, and angle 3 and angle 6 together it becomes 180. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So these many things should be very, very clear in your mind to solve second exercise. Okay, if you know these things, I mean, the journey becomes quite smooth there. Okay, so everybody got to know about this parallel line, what is a transversal, and different types of angles. So this is one level. Now next is like, everybody knows about a triangle, no, dear children? Everybody knows about triangle. What is a triangle? Can someone tell me what is a triangle? It is a three-sided closed figure, no?
Yes,
three-sided,
yes,
closed, yes, figure it is. Okay, so it is a triangle. In that triangle, three sides are there, three vertices are there, okay? So three angles are there. So A, B, C, whatever A, B, C are there, they are called as vertices, that is for sure. Then angle A, angle B, angle C are the angles, three angles. Then A, B, B, C and C, A, these are called as sides. Everything is like three. Now in this, I will give you one option here, dear children. So angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to how much it is? It is 180 degree, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes? Yes, sir. So what is this property? This is called as sum of interior angles. So they are interior, okay? Sum of interior angles of a triangle is equal to 180 degree, okay? Whichever angle you take, so all together they will be 180 degree, all interior angles. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now one more thing I will ask you now. So we have to remember this. For example, this is ABC and I have AB equal to AC. AB and AC are equal. AB is equal to AC and they have given this as the 60 degree. This is, I mean, rather than saying 60 degree, let me take it as 50 degree. Now find out angle B and angle C. Angle B equal to question mark and angle C is equal to question mark. Please do it as you know. Please do it. Consider this as the examination question and do it. And those who don't know, wait for my answer. Those who know, you can do it. And you can immediately tell the answer. Those who got the answer, you can tell immediately.
65 degrees. B is good. Equal to 65 degrees. C is equal to 65 degrees.
God, please do it. Mathematically do it. See, can I say angle B is equal to angle C is equal to X? Can I see? Because AB and AC are equal, no? So these are equal because these are the angles opposite to equal side, no? Yes or no? Vaishali, you have to write the reason like this. All of you, not only Vaishali, angles opposite to equal sides of a triangle are equal. Everybody knows that, correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Yes or no? So whatever, to this opposite side, these angles are there means they are equal. Because these kind of questions are there, that's why I'm telling you. Now we know that. What is that? Angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to what is there? 180 degree. Why? Sum of interior angles of, you have to write all this, interior angles of triangle. All these reasoning you must give. So after that, angle A is known to you. What is angle A? 50 degree. Angle B X, angle C X, that is equal to 180 degree. Correct? Can I take like this, Vaishali? X, yes. Can I take?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, definitely I can take. I have to take to make things simple. So it becomes 2x is equal to 180 degree. You know how to solve this. It becomes 2x is equal to 180 degree minus 50 degree. Then it becomes 2x is equal to 130 degree. Then it becomes x is equal to 130 degree divided by 2. So that becomes x is equal to 2 ones are 2 6, 1 is the carry 65. So 65 degree. X is equal to 65 degree. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
X is equal to 65 degree means angle B is equal to, it is X, that is equal to 65 degree, and angle C is also equal to X, that is also equal to 65 degree. Question is quite simple, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Yes, sir.
Now one more question I will give you. I will give you one triangle. Okay. Now this angle is, let me take it as 30 degree, and this one is 80 degree. Okay, ABC. Now four options are given to you, A, B, C, D. Okay, that is like AB is equal to AC, AB is greater than AC, AB is less than AC, none of the above. Which one is correct? Please tell me. A, B, C or D, which one is correct? Anyone? Okay, always remember, dear children, whichever is greater angle, no, look at this, this is greater angle, no, so side opposite to this, this will be always greater. The angle, the side opposite to greater angle is always greater. Now this is small angle, so this is like small. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, 80, yes, degree, sir. Is there, no, opposite to this, what is there? AB is there, so this AB will be always greater than this opposite to 30 degree. Opposite to 30 degree, what is there? AC is there, it is always less. AB is less than, AB is greater than AC. What is option? Here is option. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
One more thing, I see in right triangle, we have seen, no? In a right triangle, we have seen that this is ABC. I mean, this is 90 degree. Now, how about these two angles? These two angles are less than 90 degree only. Now, together, they have to be 90 degree, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? For example, if it is 40 degree and it is 50 degree, which is the largest side? Tell me. Which is the largest side in this triangle?
AC.
That is definitely opposite to 90 degree. This, yes, this is the largest angle. So, that's why largest side is AC. Now, can you tell me what is the smallest side?
AB.
No, AB is not the smallest side. BC is the smallest side. BC. Why BC? Because this is the smallest angle. Now, look at this. This 40 degree is smallest angle. Opposed to that, whatever side is there, that is the smallest side. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Are you, yes, sir. See, one more triangle I will give you. One more triangle I will give you. I will just tell you this is 30 degree. This is 50 degree, 50, 30. Otherwise, let me make it a 60, 70 degree. Okay, 70 degree. And another is, how much will be another? Tell me, other angle, how much it will be?
80
degree. Okay, let me name it as PQR. Now tell me which is the largest side?
PQ.
PQ.
PQ is the largest side, dear children. What is the smallest side?
QR.
QR. No, don't say PR. QR. Okay. So, largest angle is 80 degree. Opposite to that, whatever it is there, this is the largest side. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
30 degree is a small angle. Opposite to this, this is the smallest side. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So anyway, so this is important. So that's why I have told you this. Okay. Now do this problem, do this question. This is a right angle triangle. Okay. This is a right angle triangle. So let me name it as XYZ, and angle Y is equal to 90 degree. Angle Y is equal to 90 degree. Okay. Now they have mentioned that this XY and YZ are equal. XY is equal to YZ. Okay. Now they are asking us to find out angle X is equal to question mark, angle Z is equal to question mark. Please do it. Don't say the answer. You can say the answer, but do it as for the method. Can someone tell me the answer?
45 degrees and 45 degrees.
Okay, everybody got it. Please do it. Mathematically do it. How you are going to solve it in the exam? I want that. Do it, all of you. You are going to say angle X is equal to angle Z is equal to X, Y.
Angle supposed to equal sides are equal.
That's it. Then after that, you are going to write angle X plus angle Y plus angle Z is equal to 180 degree. The reason will be? Sum of angles of triangle. Okay. So what is the value of X? We don't know. That is X. What is the value of Y? 90 degree. What is the value of Z? X. That is equal to 180 degree. 2X is equal to 180 degree minus 90 degree. And it becomes 2X is equal to 90 degree. Sachidananda, are you there? Sachidananda. X is equal to 45 degree. Therefore, X means what I have taken. X and Z, no? Angle X is equal to X is equal to 45 degree. And next one is Z. Angle Z is equal to X is equal to 45 degree. All right. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay.
So, these things are known to you. Okay. Shall I move to next thing?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
See. There is something called, dear children, exterior angle of triangle. What is that? Exterior angle of a triangle. What is the meaning of exterior angle of a triangle? We'll see that. Exterior angle means we have this triangle, no, dear children? We have got one triangle here. Now, in this triangle, for example, you have named it. What you have named? A, B, C you have named. Now, this BC is there, no? So from this BC, if you extend this side like this, any side for that matter, if you extend this side and if you call this point as X, for example, I have called it as X, something like X I have called it, right? So, I mean, whenever I extend like this and it becomes X, I get one angle here, no? Look at this angle. Can you see the angle ACX?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
so this ACX, whatever it is there, no? This angle ACX is called, first of all, it is called as exterior angle because it is outside the triangle, that is known. And always this ACX is equal to sum of opposite angles, dear children. Opposite angles means what? I mean, see, this is external angle. Now, with this, this angle C is included. With this angle C is included, you have to leave that angle. Then you have to say angle A and angle B. I mean, this angle ACX is equal to angle A plus angle B. Is it understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
See, please try to get it. I will write the theorem at the end. Please try to get this. Not only this, I mean, you can take any triangle like this. For example, you have drawn the triangle like this. Okay. After drawing the triangle, you have named it as XYZ. As you want, you can name it XYZ. And after that, you have extended this ZY line is there, no? You have extended this ZY line. You have come like this. By extending this ZY line, you have come to this point. And let me name this point as A. No issues. Now, whatever this XYA is there, no? XYA is called as what, dear children?
Exterior angle.
And what is the value of this angle XYA? Can someone tell me? XYA is equal to what it becomes?
Angle X plus Z.
Angle Y. You have to leave this angle. This angle should be left out because this is included with this. No, you have to leave this angle. Then you have to think about other angles. X plus Z. Clear?
Yes, sir.
You can do it other thing also. For example, this is the triangle. Okay. This is a beautiful triangle what we have got, and you can name it as PQR. As you want, you can extend the line. For example, this QP is there. Now this QP you can extend like this. Okay, after extending this QP, you'll get one point here. You name this point as X now. Okay, you get one angle, no, XPR. You get angle XPR, no? Yes or no? Please tell me.
Yes, sir.
Are you confused?
Yes, sir.
Are you confused now? Are you like confused? What is this XPR? So that angle XPR is there, no? So that angle XPR means you have to leave this angle inside P, that is equal to angle Q plus angle R. Is it understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is called as external angle theorem of a triangle. What is this? External angle theorem of a triangle. Okay, do you want to know the statement? Already you got to know what is that external angle of a theorem. The statement says, for this theorem, everybody is going to write this statement, that is that external angle of a triangle is equal to sum of opposite internal angles of triangle. Okay, opposite to this, what are there? These are there, no? These two are there. And opposite to this, what are there? These are there, no? I mean, opposite to this, what are there? These are there, no? This won't come. Okay, in this it won't come, in this it won't come, other two angles. Understood?
Yes, sir.
External angle of a triangle is equal to sum of opposite internal angles of triangle. Do you want to prove it, dear children? Do you want the proof?
Yes, sir.
They will ask for the proof also. Okay,
yes, sir.
They will ask you a state external angle theorem of triangle and prove it. State means you have to write the statement, and after that you have to prove it. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So let's look into the proof. First of all, for this proof, we need one diagram like this. This is a diagram what we have. Okay, this is the triangle. I'm going to name this triangle as ABC. Then I'm going to extend this BC to one more line, and we'll call it as X. Okay. So now what I'm supposed to prove? To prove angle ACX is equal to angle A plus angle B, right? Correct?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
This is what I'm supposed to prove. Let me put the heading proof, and I mean already I have put it, and let me do it. Okay. Now can I say angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree? Why I'm saying like that?
Sum of interior angles of triangle,
right? So this is what I'm going to say. Now after that, equation number one, can I say angle ACB plus angle ACX is equal to 180 degree? Can I say like that?
Yes, sir.
Why? Angles on straight line, no?
Yes, sir.
Angles, yes. On straight line. Yes, sir. Yes or no? Angles on straight. You have to just mention like this. Angles on straight line. This is more than enough. Angles on straight line. So whatever angles are there on the straight line, they are going to be 180 degree. That is like ACB and ACX together. Don't you think it becomes a semicircle like this?
Yes, sir.
So it is 180 degree now. So everybody knows that. So angle ACB, instead of this angle ACB, look at this ACB angle comes like this, no? Can I say it as angle C, just angle C? Can I say?
Yes, sir.
Can I say or not? ACB means just angle C plus angle ACX means angle ACX, that is equal to 180 degree. Clear, dear children? Now, can you see that? Equation two it is. Now, can you see that RHS of equation number one is equal to RHS of equation number two? No, dear children? RHS 180 yes. degree, and here also 180 degree, correct?
Yes, sir.
So if RHS are equal, then therefore LHS of equation number one will become LHS of equation number two or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. If RHS are equal, LHS become equal. So that's why it becomes angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to angle C plus angle ACX, correct? Correct now?
Yes, sir.
So this angle C and angle C will get cancelled. If you reverse this, you'll get to know that angle ACX is equal to angle A plus angle B. What was there to prove? This was the prove, right? This was asked to be proved, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So we proved it. It's quite simple, no, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? Okay, so this is quite simple. Everybody must have got to know how to do it. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, shall we do one more proof like this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So they will ask you a question. Prove that vertically opposite angles are equal to each other. Vertically opposite angles are equal to each other. We know that vertically opposite angles are equal to each other, but we have to prove it now. Shall we prove it?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. Let's yes, see. Sir. I mean, this is one line, no, dear children? And this yes, is sir. One more line, right? This is one more line. So let me name them. Let me name it as AB and CD. I have named it as AB and CD. And they are intersecting at point O, correct? This is the point O. All right, dear children?
Yes, yes, sir.
So let me write it as AB and CD are intersecting. AB and CD are intersecting at point O. At point O, they are intersecting. This is a point O. All right. Now, how many angles we have here, dear children? We have four angles. No, that is angle 1, angle 2. Angle 3, angle 4, no?
Yes,
yes,
sir.
Now,
yes,
what
sir.
We have to prove? To prove, what we have to prove? We have to prove angle 1 is equal to angle 3, right? Or angle 2 is equal to angle 4. Anything is fine. Any one is fine. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Angle 1 is equal to angle 3 or angle 2 is equal to angle 4. This is what we need to prove. Any one, not both. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, do you guys agree that DOC is a straight line?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
DOC is a straight line, no? DOC is a straight line means, will you agree that angle 2 plus angle 1 is equal to 180 degree?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Yes or no? Because both are, I mean, they are called supplementary angles, no? So you can just write supplementary angles, or you can write angle of straight line. Angle of straight line is 180 degree. You can write like this, no? Any reason you can give. Any one related reason you can give. Right, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Now, let me write it as equation number 1. So I'm going to write it as equation number 1. Is it okay? Angle 2 plus angle 1 is equal to 180 degree?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Now, similarly, don't you think AOB is also straight line?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir. AOB is a straight line or not? Tell me. Okay. Straight if line, AOB sir. Is a straight line, angle 1 plus angle 4 is equal to 180 degree or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Why?
Yes, sir.
No need to write the reason now. Already you gave the reason there. No need to give the reason now. Only once you have to give the reason. Same reason you should not give again and again. Different reason means you can give, but same reason you should not give again and again. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, can you see that RHS of equation number 1 is equal to RHS of equation number 2? Can you see that? Both are 180 degree?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, or no? So, RHS of equation number 1 and RHS of equation number 2 means, what can I write? I can write LHS of equation number 1 is equal to LHS of equation number 2 or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
what
sir.
Is LHS
yes,
of sir. Equation number 1? Angle 2 plus angle 1 is equal to angle 1 plus angle 4. 1 and 1 get cancelled. and angle 2 is equal to angle 4. Was this asked in prove section to prove?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
It's not like both you have to prove. Any one you have to prove. We proved it. Angle 2 equal to angle 4. Over. Clear?
Yes,
yes
sir.
Yes, sir.
So, did you learn about these two proofs, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, these two proofs are known to you. Now, I think first and second exercise, so easily you can do. And third exercise also you can attempt. So all things are clear now. So will you remember these proofs? Will you practice these proofs, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So practice them so that you get to know about the things. Okay. Okay. Next, what else we want to understand? So these things are understood. Now I think it is time for us to go into exercise. Right, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's see into the exercise. Already you guys must be having the textbook, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Do you guys have the textbook or not? Okay, already the textbook must be there, 9th textbook. I have downloaded also lines and angles. Here also, I mean, everything will be crystal clear. I was looking into all this exercise. What are the things available? I think we have to start our journey from first exercise. Right, dear children?
Yes, sir.
So, have you tried these questions, all of these questions, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, now your task is to, today is your task is to solve all the questions from this first exercise. Any doubts means those will be rectified. All right, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, you have to do that. Now everybody do first question, even though if you have solved it, do it. First question, all of you. Quickly do it. Write down this first question, all of you. Please do it. In figure 6.13, they have given the figure also. Line AB and CD intersect at O. AB is here. This is the AB and CD. They are intersecting at O. If AOC plus BOE is equal to 70 degree, AOC means you understand, no? This is AOC and BOE. What is BOE? Here is BOE. So together it is 70 degree. Then how much it will be? This angle? 110 degree, no? Dear children?
Yes.
Yeah, you should get those kind of hints. And angle BOD is 40 degree. And this angle is like 40 degree. This is 40 degree. And this together are 70 degree. Now they are asking, find BOE. What is BOE? Where is BOE? And this BOE they are asking. Okay. So this angle they are asking. We'll try to find it out. Okay. What is this BOE? Okay. This BOE they are asking. And what else they are asking? They are asking reflex of COE. First of all, we have to find out COE. This is COE we'll find out. And reflex of COE, I will tell you. What is reflex of COE? Okay. COE easily you can find out, no, dear children? This angle easily you can find out, no?
Yes, sir.
So you can easily do that. How you are going to do that? Okay, step by step. Step by step you have to do. What you have to write? You have to write AOB is a straight line, no? Yes or no? What you have to write? AOB is a straight line. You have to write like this, first of all. If AOB is a straight line means, angle AOC plus angle COE plus angle BOE or EOB. Anything is fine. It is equal to 180 degree, no? Correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Now, they have mentioned AOC plus BOE is equal to 70 degree. That means AOC and BOE means EOB. Anything is fine. So, that is equal to 70 degree that is given. Plus angle COE. That is equal to 180 degree. So therefore, angle COE is equal to 180 degree minus 70 degree. So therefore, angle COE becomes 110 degree. Right, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? COE is over, no? COE thing is over or not? One answer is over now.
Yes, sir.
Now, what else we want? We want BOE. BOE means here it is BOE, this angle we want. How to do with this? Now tell me, dear children. So this one is given as 40 degree. This angle, this DOB is given as 40 degree or BOD is 40 degree. Don't you think AOC is also 40 degree? Why? Because they are vertically opposite angles, no? Because this line AB, here is the line AB, and here is the line CD. So this is the angle CD. Okay, so this is like DOB. Here is O. DOB is 40 degree, means this COA or AOC is also 40 degree or not?
Yes, sir.
So this OE line came extra, so that's a different issue. Whatever OE line is there, that is extra. Now don't you think AOC is 40 degree?
Yes
or no? So what I will write here, angle AOC is equal to angle BOD. Why? Because they are vertically opposite angles, right? Vertically opposite angles. So AOC is equal to BOD. Angle AOC is equal to BOD means 40 they have given. It is 40 degree. But we don't want AOC. We want a BOE. This angle we want. Okay. And everybody knows angle AOC plus angle BOE is equal to 70 degree because it is given. It is a given data. Okay. So AOC is 40 degree and angle BOE that together is equal to 70 degree. Now angle BOE is equal to 70 degree minus 40 degree. Don't you think it is 30 degree, children?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So this become quite simple, no? It is.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this are you facing any problem with this solution? Whatever I have solved here, are you facing any trouble here?
No, sir. Right?
No, sir.
Everything is clear, no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes, after that, I'm going to rub it off. Then I'm going to move on to second question. Okay, fine then. Now we don't want COE also. Whatever COE is there, we don't want COE. We want reflex of COE. Try to understand what is it. Everybody wrote this, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I hope everybody wrote this. I'm going to rub it off. Yes or no? Everybody has to make note. This notes you won't get. That whatever I have explained in the class, that you will get. But this one, solution and all, you won't get because I'll be rubbing it off here only. Because I have to get through the textbook and all, no? So that's why. Now, reflex means, try to understand this, dear children. Reflex of any angle means, for example, if they're asking reflex of 30 degree. What do you mean by reflex of 30 degree? I have got one angle here, which is like 30 degree. This is the angle 30 degree. Reflex means anything other than this. So that is like 360 degree minus 30 degree. So that is equal to 330 degree. So reflex of 30 degree is 330. Is it understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, so what is a reflex? What is the reflex of 90 degree? Please tell me. Reflex of 90 degree means you have to do 360 degree minus 90 degree. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Reflex of any angle means 360 minus you have to do that. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So this is the data what I have given you. So now what is the reflex of COE? Reflex of COE, they are asking, no? Reflex of angle COE is equal to 360 degree minus angle COE. So 360 degree minus COE means 110 degree. We found out that. So it becomes 250 degree. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
I hope it is clear.
Yes, sir. Okay,
fine then. So I think everybody can write that. Will you try all the problems like this, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth and all? So tomorrow,
yes, sir.
when I enter into the class, the first question what I will ask is
doubts
in first exercise. Okay, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Okay, please do that. Please do this. And we'll look into this exercise. This is very simple exercise. Right now I can do that, but I'm giving chance for other people, those who haven't solved. Those who haven't solved, I'm giving a chance for them so that they are also able to solve all this. Okay, dear children?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay then, all of you take care. And one more thing I just wanted to announce. See, let me end the class and let me announce that. Okay, all right. Thank you very much. Have a good day, everyone.